Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna check out the new and improved cloud selection in Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to select and click on that subscribe button and leave a like and comment what you think about it. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so first of all, make sure that you have the latest release of Photoshop Beta. So this one is 26.5, as you can see, this is the release that it have. Maybe by the time you are watching this, you will find this selection update with all the other Adobe platforms, from the official Photoshop to Illustrator to After Effects, because I think it's really cool and I'm sure Adobe will push this to the other products. Alright, the other thing that you have to do is to make sure that in the preferences in here, you can open them by pressing Ctrl Command K and then go into the image processing. Make sure that you have cloud in here in the select subject and remove background. Make sure that you have it set to cloud to have a better detailed result that like they say in here, and press OK. Alright, now the other thing that I want to mention is this selection work best when you have a better or a good quality image. So don't expect to have a good, decent selection using a lower resolution image. I mean, most of the people who are showing this, they have a really good resolution image. That's why it works very sharp, very crisp. In fact, I have a low resolution image. As you can see, this is only 200 kilobytes. So we'll go and open this, and in here you will have your bar. If you don't have it open, just go to window and make sure that you have contextual taskbar in here checked. So in here you can select the subject or remove background. The other way to do this, you can just go to select and choose subject, and let's wait for it to progress. As you can see, you will have your selection, but if I zoom in, it's not as detailed as it should be or as it expected from a lot of people. Now, because we have a low resolution image, now if I apply a layer mask on this, you will see that it actually did a really decent selection, knowing that it's a very low resolution image. So yeah, just make sure that you have a good quality image and try this out. All right so let's close this, and actually let's open a good quality image this time. Let's go with this one, and then I will select the subject and wait for it to progress again. All right now if I zoom in, you can see the Martian ants are everywhere. Maybe not in some parts, in these areas, maybe in here, but yeah, it did actually a really amazing detail selection. This will probably take me more than 2 hours, or I think even more than that. I mean, I always avoid to make selection with bicycles and wires, because you will need to do a lot of work to select everything in a detailed possible way. So yeah, I think this is a really nice selection. So I will go ahead and apply a layer mask. And again, if I zoom in, you can see even the hair is sharp selected, which is really, really cool. This will save a lot of time at making selection. I mean, it's not 100% perfect, but I would say it's like 90 or 95. You can just add the details that you don't have, maybe this part of the seat, and I mean, there are minor details comparing to the amount of details that we have in here. All right so this is really cool. So let's close this one and let's go and open another image, this one in here. So we'll make a selection, or I will select subject. All right as you can see, we have our selection. Now if I zoom in, this is not perfect either, but for the sake of the tutorial, I'm not gonna actually edit this. So we'll just one click on the layer mask, and as you can see, this is actually really bothering me. So let's actually grab a brush real quick, and maybe I will fast forward this, and let's try to fix this. All right, I think it looks a little bit better. Okay, I think the wheel part is really nice. Maybe it needs a little bit more work, but yeah, maybe I can fix that later. All right, now we'll actually go and open an image of a city above, and I will put it below the couple image, and let's press Ctrl Command T and make it smaller. I want it to look like they are flying on top or above the city, so let's actually do that. Make it smaller. That's right here. I want also the sun to be in this area, maybe in the center. Yeah, maybe move the couple a little bit higher, and let's actually keep it in this area. All right, I think it looks cool. Now let's actually generate the rest of the background. So I will select the pixels, or I will make a selection of this image of the city by pressing Ctrl Command and one click on this icon. You can actually load the selection, or you can just right click and choose select pixels. Next, I will go to select and choose modify and choose contract. I will keep this set to 50 pixels and I will press OK. Now I will need to actually inverse this selection, so I will go back to select, and this time I will choose inverse, or you can press shift Ctrl I or shift Command I, and this will inverse it. Now I will go and select generate and generate. Then we'll wait for it to progress. All right, as you can see, we have three variations that we can choose from. Let's actually choose the best one. Maybe I believe the second one is decent. Yeah, perfect. I think I will go with the second one. And yeah, it's already started to look really cool. I want actually to match the colors of the couple with the background. So I will select the couple layer, and then I will go to image, adjustment, and choose match color. And by the way, this match color option, it won't work if you have a smart object. So yeah, just make sure that you don't have it as a smart object. All right, now we have the preview is on, which means that we can see live what's going on. So let's actually choose the source to the couple layer, and then let's actually change the layer 0 to generative fill, and as you can see, it will match the colors from the background to the couple. But I think it's a little bit strong, so let's actually put up the luminance a little bit, maybe 125, and let's play with the color intensity. I think I want it to be more colorful, maybe 130. And let's fade it a little bit, maybe 15 or 20. Perfect. Let's go and see before and after. Yeah, I think it looks really cool. So I will press OK. All right, perfect. Now, the other thing that I want to add is a little bit of flare in this area, just to have it to blend even better. So let's create a new layer, and let's fill this with black by going to Edit and choose Fill, or you can press Shift 5, and in the contents in here, make sure that you are choosing black and press OK. All right, now we'll go to Filter, and I will choose Render, and I will choose Lens Blur. Now you can choose from 4 lens types. For me, I always go with the first one, but go ahead and experiment with this. So yes, I will keep it simple in this one in here. Maybe I will make it a little bit brighter. Yeah, something like that. And I will press OK. And then I'm going to change the blending mode of this to screen. And I will put it maybe in here. All right, I think it looks really cool. Now we can always apply a layer mask and maybe load the selection of the couple by pressing Ctrl or Command and one click on the layer mask this time, and this will load the selection. Now you can go and grab a brush and you know, start deleting from the areas that you don't want the light basically to be shown. Maybe I would put down the flow very low, maybe around 20 with 100% opacity. And let's paste Ctrl Command H to hide the selection or the Martian ants. Maybe I would put down the flow even more, and I will start the bleeding a little bit from the areas as I think it's a little bit strong. Yeah, just to make them blend even better. Alright, I think it looks really cool. Let's press Ctrl Command H again. But I can see a little bit of the background of the lens flare. And to fix that, you can just apply a level adjustment and clip it to the lens flare. And then you can play with the midtones to make the background actually disappear. Alright, as you can see, let's actually make it a little bit less, yeah, something like that. And there we go, as you can see, we made a really nice composite with this really cool improved selection. So I hope that you enjoyed and you liked this video and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know where it's for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.